Good morning. So there's this passage in Genesis 20 that I've always found intriguing. Abraham has told King Abimelech that Sarah is his sister. And God comes to King Abimelech in a dream. And he says, "Behold, you're a dead man, because the woman with whom you have taken, she is another man's wife." Now, I think that's interesting because King Abimelech later says to God, "But I have done what I have done in the integrity of my heart. My hands are innocent. I was lied to." And God says, "Yes, I know, and that's why I've spared your life." I thought about that because there is a lot to be said about the integrity of our heart. And I wonder, what's the integrity of your heart? What's the integrity of my heart? The passage is also interesting to me because Isaac did the same sin. He did the same thing. That's one of the problems in life, is that the sins of the fathers come upon the children and the generations after them. A lot of things that we do, we've done because, well, we've learned it. As the saying that I've used a lot says, that what we live with, we learn, and what we learn, we practice, and what we practice, we become. But the point of this time this morning is about the integrity of your heart because, well, God looks at that. And one of the things that I know is that is the, in the integrity of our heart, we can have a lot of grace with God. But when you do things out of an evil heart, when you do things out of a prideful heart, out of an arrogant heart, out of an angry heart, God doesn't give us latitude. He calls us to task about that. And so the challenge for you and me is to look at our hearts today. God says, through his word, that we are to ask him to search our hearts and show us if there's anything wicked in us. That's a good prayer. It's a good thing to do. I think that walking in the integrity of our heart should be the desire and the plan of every day. But we don't always do that. We don't always do that because, well, like Abraham, we're afraid and we lie. We do other things. We put ourselves in situations that we never should have put ourselves in. And we act accordingly. So my challenge simply today is, walk in the integrity of your heart. Think about that as you're going about your day, doing whatever's in your day to do. And walk in a manner that demonstrates integrity. Hey, until next time, God bless.